And then we decided to have a science fair, because I'd always wanted a science fair and I'd never lived in a place that had a science fair. So we organized a science fair, and we had a very good science teacher, Mrs. Sinha. And so she was supportive of this. And we had fantastic laboratory, a fantastic chemistry laboratory. And yeah, it was a really great equipment in the school. Not very many teachers used it. But Mrs. Sinha was very happy to let us use the chemistry lab. So I went and started experimenting with all the great glassware in the chemistry lab. And one thing I found was this great sulfur dioxide generator. So I don't know how I figured out what it was. But you put iron sulfide and sulfuric acid in it. And if you arranged it right, you could just turn on the spigot and it would let the sulfur dioxide out, which you could use for analytic chemistry. And then it would raise the sulfur dioxide to the level of the iron oxide and then generate some gas and push it back down. So it was a great system that would generate sulfur dioxide whenever you needed it. This wonderful teacher actually taught us analytic chemistry from this. And so we would get substances and we would have to analyze them. It was really a fantastic chemistry education. But I decided to hook up the sulfur dioxide generator, but I hooked it up upside down with the iron sulfide on the bottom. I didn't quite understand the principle of it. So you couldn't turn it off. So we had to evacuate the entire school because it smells like rotten eggs. While they rid it of the sulfur dioxide generator.